In this video, I'm going to explain the ligament around sternum and clavicle. These ligaments are very important for clavicle stability and sternum stability and breathing. And these ligaments can affect shoulder joints. So these ligaments are very important for upper limb. So what is this red one? This red tape connects sternum and clavicle. So this red tape is sternoclavicular ligament. Okay, sternoclavicular ligament. And what is this yellow one? This yellow one looks like it connects rib and clavicle. So this is costoclavicular ligament. The costo means rib in anatomical words. So this is costoclavicular ligament. This ligament is actually deeper than it looks. But for sake of this video, I just show you the simplified version of location. This ligament is deeper than it looks, okay? Costoclavicular ligament. And this black one looks like it kind of spreads this way, right? Spreads. So name of this ligament is radiate sternocostal ligament. Radiate means like a spread. Radiate sternocostal ligament. So there is a pair, and of course there is the ligament below this rib cage. This is a rib 2. Of course there is this ligament on rib 3, rib 4, rib 5. Okay, I'm just showing you the one place of this ligament. And you see there is the blue ligament right here. This is a superior view. This ligament kind of connects the two clavicle, okay? Two clavicle. So this is interclavicular ligament. Inter, in between clavicle. So this is interclavicular ligament. Review of ligament around sternum. This is sternoclavicular ligament. And this is costoclavicular ligament. This is radiate sternocostal ligament. This blue one is interclavicular ligament. So the ligament around sternum and clavicle are very, very complicated, and there are a lot of ligaments than maybe you might think. So these ligaments are very important for stability for thorax, rib cage, scapula, and shoulder. Let's go to little bit lateral part of the clavicle, okay? So you see two green ligaments. This medial one, inside one is conoid ligament, and this one is trapezoid ligament. Conoid ligament and trapezoid ligament. Oftentimes, these two ligaments together, it is called coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoclavicular ligament. Simple enough, right? And you see the striped ligament, this one, yellow and green striped ligament. This connects coracoid process and acromion. So this is coracoacromion ligament. Coracoacromion ligament. And there is a ligament on top of clavicle, this one. This ligament connects acromion and clavicle. So this is acromioclavicular ligament. Acromioclavicular ligament. This is coracoacromion ligament. This is acromioclavicular ligament, okay? So in this video, I explained the ligament around sternum and clavicle. Review, this is sternoclavicular ligament. This is costoclavicular ligament. Radiate sternocostal ligament. And this blue one is interclavicular ligament. Green ligaments, the medial one is conoid ligament. This is trapezoid ligament. This green yellow stripe one, this is coracoacromion ligament. On top of clavicle and acromion, this is acromioclavicular ligament. These ligaments are very important for whole thorax, rib cage, and for shoulder movement. If these ligaments get tight, it can inhibit shoulder movement. Why? Because when you move shoulder, the clavicle should move freely. If clavicle doesn't move, your scapula doesn't move. If scapula doesn't move, shoulder does not move. Of course, ligaments around shoulder joint or muscles around shoulder joints are very important. But if you think about these ligaments, maybe you have new idea for your clinical experience and maybe for training experience. I hope this video helps your understanding of ligament around thorax. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.